Welcome to Harbor Speaks. Today we're going to be talking with the Pharaoh's Car Club, and they'll be showing us their annual car show and toy drive here at the Wilmington Athletic Complex. My name is Mike Herrera. For 40 years, I've worked in the nonprofit field. During this time, I've noticed there were hundreds of nonprofits, organizations, and individuals making a positive difference in the community. My mission is twofold: to inform the community of these services and to recruit help for these programs. Hey, I'm here with Russell Martinez, one of the coordinators of today's event. And Russell, how long have you guys been doing this?
Well, together we started out as a few clubs doing this at one time. It's been about 10, 12, 15 years now we've been doing this for the community. And one club took over it, which was the Road Kings, and then the Pharaohs took over after that. So now the Pharaohs are doing this, and we try to benefit the kids in the harbor area, and we circle it around San Pedro, Wilmington, Harbor City. And this year, our person that we're giving it to today is Mike at the Wilmington Teen Center. He's being awarded the gifts today. Whatever we collect goes to them. It's all about the kids, you guys. It's all about these guys right here showing all the clubs that come here, the Viejitos, the Old Memories, the other Pharaohs, the Road Kings come over here. There's others here that these new ones that I just seen, I forget the name of them, something, I can't remember the name. But they're right here, they're new. This is their first time here and they're enjoying it. We got people all the way from Indio that came out here. We got some old original Pharaohs that came, and now they're coming with their kids. So the kids are taking after their parents. It's a good thing that comes down here.
The kids will benefit by getting a toy. You have to donate a toy to be in the show?
Well, we kind of try to encourage everybody. I myself try to encourage everybody. When they ask me, well, what do we got to do? I go, bring a gift, a boy and a girl. Yeah. So that way we double up. But it doesn't always work that way, which is okay. The vendors, we always get vendors here. They make whatever they make. But that's all we ask for. We don't even charge them. We make no money off them. We just ask them, bring toys. Because it's, like I said, it's all about these kids. Some of these kids out here, you know, are unfortunate enough, the families are going through hard times, bad times, or just poor poverty. And somebody's got to give them something. We got to give them something, you guys. I mean, half of us have probably been there ourselves when we're kids. So that's what we just try to give back to the community. And let them all know how these lowriders right here are not about what people think they are. They're about family. These guys are all about family. Look at these cars that are here today. They're beautiful. I mean, come on, look at this work of art. It's an art for these guys.
Thank you very much. This is awesome what you guys do, and we really appreciate it, kids. Hey, I'm here with Pete Cruz of the Latin Gents Car Club of Southern California, and he's going to tell us about his car here. Pete, how long have you had this car?
I think I bought it in 2011. So 8 years now, going to nine, something like that.
Really? Have you done a lot of work on it?
Yeah, I did everything. Everything. It didn't look nothing like it when I bought it.
Really?
I bought it in Santa Maria.
Wow. How did you find it?
I was at the car show over there, and the guy had it for sale. And I've always wanted to get a 40 unit. I used to have a, back in the day, I had a 50 fleet line, I had a 51 fleet line, and 48s and everything, and 39s. I decided I want to get a four-door this time because I always liked the four-door. So I had a four-door there for sale, and I picked it up and had it brought back.
That's good. Hey, Pete, besides working on your car, what do you do in real life here?
I'm retired. That's why I bought the car. I retired. I needed another hobby, so I decided to buy a car. I used to have these back in the day, like I said, and then, you know, life, you know, changed, you know, and I had to sell them. And I said, well, I need to get back into the life again and cruise and, you know, hang out with the guys and all that. You know?
I know when I was in high school, car clubs had a real bad name, usually related to lowrider gangs and stuff.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
But you know, now most of them are older, retired people.
Yeah.
Like us.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
And they have some real great cars, you know. So.
Yeah, I grew up here in Wilmington, so you know, I live in San Pedro now, but I grew up here in Eastside. Yeah.
Right. Great. Thank you very much, Pete.
Okay. All right.
Hey, I'm here with Hector Ortiz. He's the president of the Latin Gents Car Club of Southern California. How you doing?
I'm doing fine. How's it going?
Good, good. Now, are you, as a car club, you guys help each other out, work on cars together?
Yeah, that's what it's all about. Yeah, we work all together. Yeah, we help.
That's awesome. How long did it take you to actually get this car in the shape it's in?
This one here took me about 3 years. About 3 years, yeah. Uh-huh.
Wow.
Little by little.
Wow.
3 years.
So how long have your carpet club been together?
You know, let me tell you a little history of the Latin Gents. Latin Gents started in Orange County back in 61. My oldest brother was in there. And the club, it was just a social club, so sort of, it wasn't a car club. Car club started like in 65. Had about 125 members at the time. Then Vietnam was going on. A lot of guys got drafted, a lot of guys, you know, volunteered. So it kind of broke up. So then the club got back up off and on. And then in 2008, I started the club again. And that's where we're at now.
Wow.
The Latin Gents.
You guys are doing a great job. These cars look better than brand new to me.
Yeah, they're pretty clean. They're pretty clean.
Yeah.
They're clean. Yeah.
So what did you do before you worked on cars? Did you retire now?
Yeah, I'm retired. I'm retired.
What kind of work did you do?
I'm a Teamster.
Teamster?
Yeah, I used to move heavy equipment. Yeah.
Awesome. That's good. And all these guys are family or friends? Or?
Yeah, family and friends, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. So we're going. We're still going strong. Yeah.
Great. So based in Orange County, what city?
City of Stanton. That's where the Latin Gents started at. City of Stanton. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Stanton. They call it Stanton.
Stanton.
Yeah.
All right. Sounds good, man. But it looks great, you know.
Right.
And, you know, car clubs have had, bad reputation of being gangsters and gangs and stuff. And, you know, this, to me, now the imitation is so much better than that now, because it's usually a bunch of older people that really know, have a passion for good vintage.
Yeah, for the automobiles. Yeah, we have a big passion over it. And yeah, we all get along. We, you know, everybody's showing off their cars and stuff. And that's what it's all about. And having a good time, you know.
And as a social group, what do you guys do? Do you help the community?
Put it this way, like Ronnie King says, can't we all just get along?
Yeah.
You know, hey, that's what it's all about. Get along with each other. And have a good
great time. Thank you very much, Hector. Appreciate it. I'm here with Bill Mann. He's from the Travel On
Racing team
here.
Retired.
Here's an old club here that he's going to tell us a little bit about some of his history. So tell me, how long is this? When did this club start?
We started in the middle to late 50s, and we ran through the middle 60s. Our Northwest chapter is still in existence. There's still a few of them racing, but as far as the original LA group, there's only two of us left alive, as near as I can tell.
Well, now, what kind of cars did you race?
We raced down here. We raced a AA altered 32 Ford with a big Lincoln engine in it. Our Northwest chapter had a couple of dragsters, a competition coupe. One of the guys is building a new AA fuel altered, but all strictly competition cars.
Now, how did you get involved in this?
Well, I was a mascot for the club from the age of 12. Oh. You couldn't join until you were 18. I joined when I was 18. And then I got hooked up with Studebaker when I was factory sponsored by Studebaker in 63.
Wow.
And moved on from there, racing a little bit of everything over the years.
Well, now Studebaker's long gone now. What are they still, do they still have a club too?
No, they weren't part of the club. Studebaker Corporation built the Studebaker Lark, the Avanti, the Hawk. I used to race a Lark along with the Granatelli team.
So what was the purpose of the Travelon? Did you guys help anything in the community or anything like that?
Well, we were a drag race team. And the LA chapter didn't do much in the community. The Northwest chapter did. They used to put on fuel and gas championships. The governor would come out and present the trophies. The money was donated to charities.
Good.
So it was a good
so
organization.
Were you like in the old Lowell Lions drag strip?
Yeah, we raced Lions drag strip, San Fernando, Fontana, San Gabriel.
See, we're giving our age away here, see, because, you know, the Lions drag strip has been gone for a long, long time, but that was really popular.
Gone even longer.
Yeah. Hey, anyway, thank you very much. Appreciate you.
My pleasure. Thanks. Nice talking to you.
I'm here with our two youngest members of the car club. And what is your name here?
Nyla.
And what is your name?
Sophia.
This is Nyla and Sophia. Which car belongs to your parents?
A red burgundy car.
How about you?
That one
right there. Do you like it? Do you help him fix it up? He won't let you touch it, huh?
He does sometimes.
All right. Hey, this is Mike again. Hey, what is your name?
Tony. Tony.
Tony Barnagle,
yeah.
Tony, what's the name of your group?
Rose Sinners.
Wow.
Rose, so Torrance.
They're in Torrance.
Yeah.
All right. So how long have you had this car? This is a little bit different, because...
Oh, yeah. I have had this car for about 6 years now. Had it sitting in my driveway for about 2 and finally got it going. So I've been driving it about 3 years now.
So is it harder to get parts for an old Buick than it would be for an old Chevy?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. There's no aftermarket stores that sell anything for Buicks. You have to go shopping for it. You have to look around. Yeah. Luckily, this came with almost everything on there, so I hadn't really need to get anything. Yeah. Besides the motor. Actually, the motor and training. When I got it, didn't have the motor or training in it. So I had to resource that and look around for it.
You got a new motor in there now?
Yeah. Well, the original motor just rebuilt. Rebuilt training.
Can we have a look at it? Cool. Wow, that is really clean.
Yeah, so that's the original 322 and Dynaflow transmission in it. They come like that.
You worked on that yourself?
Oh, yeah. Did everything myself.
Wow.
Did everything chrome. Me and my brother helped me.
Yeah. So, yeah. Are you a mechanic?
No, this is what I learned off of. Oh. it's I had a lot of guys that work on Chevys, and I try to ask them about work on this, and it's a whole different beast.
Yeah, a different animal, but it's different. You know, that's what I like about it.
That's why I didn't go with the 350. Everybody has a 350.
Wow.
So, I wanted the original nailhead.
So, where did you find this car?
I found it in Riverside. It used to be owned to a serviceman who went overseas. He had his car in the shop. He had his motor in the shop. The motor shut down. The shop shut down, and he was out a motor, so he just sold the car.
Wow.
So,
I gave up on it. Well, that's awesome. You kind of took over, and it's still a work in progress. So.
Oh yeah. It has original paint, all that. I don't want to mess with it.
So. Yeah, I know. Cars like this, you almost, you never finish working on it. No. It's always something.
No, it's something you love doing, though. So
how did you get involved with this car show?
My friends group, you know, they all Pharaohs. Everybody knows Pharaoh, so come out here and do a good thing for the kids. Bring some toys out here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, cool. I'm here with the president of the
Road Centers, the South Bay Road Centers.
And your name is?
Richard Lopez.
Richard Lopez, how long have you guys been together?
Going on 15 years. Yeah, I brought the club up, and I was able to establish 19 members at one time. And we did all the Pharaohs, the Legends, and all the car shows back then. And we rolled with the least. Probably 9 cars at a given time. We lost a lot of members due to health problems.
Yeah.
But the club is still going. Originally it's from La Rana, and I got one of the original plaques right now in the 54 from one of the original members back in 1954. That's when the Road Center started in the old little barrio in Torrance called La Rana. And
how long have you had this car?
This car I've had 20 years. And I restored it by myself.
So you did the paint job and everything?
Except the paint, and I did some of the upholstery, but except the paint, I got it ready for paint, and I took it all apart, and I sent it out to Long Beach.
Awesome. And can we have a look at the inside?
Yeah, sure. Are you doing the part?
With the wow, that is beautiful.
Brakes, power steering, it's got power brakes, power steering, power windows, power front seat, power brakes.
Now, is that standard in a car like this?
It was factory. It was a factory option
thing. Wow. I didn't know they had the factory option like this.
1953 started with some options.
In 1953?
1953 it started with some options, yeah.
So the year after I was born.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I can show you the inside as well.
Let's have a look at the inside here. Oh, it's a two-door.
Two-door hardtop. You can see it.
Now, did you get all these upholstery done and everything?
Yeah, it's factory. It's a Hampton Coach. It's a kit from Hampton Coach to the original specs, the power brakes, the power steering.
Did it come with a spotlight right here?
Yes, that's factory. Yeah.
Wow.
Everything came with it.
Let me ask you this. What is this little thing right here? What is that?
That's a sun visor viewer. When the signals were up in the middle, where you could see the light from there, it would reflect. It's like a reflection.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, instead of looking down, it would reflect. You could see the...
So you can see where the light changes.
The light changes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
Wow, this thing is so beautiful. I shouldn't have touched it. I'm sorry. I cleaned it.
That's okay. That's fine.
Hey, this is Howie with Custom Oldies Cars, East Los Angeles.
What do you want me? I'm Howie. They call me Howie. I'm from Custom Oldies, East LA.
Wow. Is this your car right here?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. How long have you been working on it?
I've had it for 23 years.
Wow. So are you in charge of your car club, or is this?
No, well, I am in a way, I'm not. Custom Oldies founder and Oscar Rubles asked me to come to help them straighten out that club. So, yeah, remember, Custom Oldies is a huge organization now.
Yeah.
And we do a lot, too. But sometimes these clubs, to where they don't want to do nothing.
So how long have you been involved with this particular car show?
Long time, because I used to be with the Pharaohs.
Yeah.
And I've always still support them. There's always a saying, once a Pharaoh is always a Pharaoh.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
But I've been low riding since I was 14 years old.
Wow, you had a car when you were 14?
Yes, I did. Okay.
Uh-oh.
There are some stories that have been too long, but I used to shine shoes for the sailors and made a lot of money.
Really?
And I was 14 years old. I was walking down. There was a 52 Chevy. And I went in there. How much? He said, about 200. I said, I'll be right back. And he goes, are you old enough to drive? I said, you want the money? He says, yeah. I says, give me the car. So I got the car. I took it home. Went to school the next day. Next day I come home. I went and dropped it. Put pipes. And that's when my lowrider years really started. And
What school was that?
I went to Banning.
Went to Banning?
Yeah.
So, once a pilot, always a pilot.
Yes, it is. Okay. But what I have to do is I want to introduce the community what lowriding is about. Okay. It's not being a gangster. It's something that we go out there and work on our cars. And what we have to do? Let the community know what we do. Get kids off the street and start them to learn to work on a car.
Well, thank you very much. A lot of kids are going to benefit from your help. Thank you. Hi, we're here with Luis Vasquez. He's the vice president of which club?
Viejitos Harbor Area.
In the Harbor Area, yeah. How long have you had your car club together?
We celebrated our first year anniversary about a month ago.
Wow. Who started the club? Was it you?
Our president, Carlos. Mesas, yes,
right.
He started.
And these are your two feature cars here, right?
Well, they're two of just two members here today and a prospect. But we have a total of six members right now.
Wow. So yeah. What year is your car here?
54 Chevy, 3100.
54
yeah.
Chevy.
Yes.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Thank you.
Can you open the trunk? Can
sure.
We have a look at it? Wow, that is clean. Wow. How long have you been working on this car?
It took about 2 years for the guy to rebuild it. Because when I bought it, it was from the Oldies Car Club. And it really wasn't my truck. But now it is my truck because it has my paint on it, my interior. And I'm proud of it. And the guy that did that built it, Johnny Morales, he did a good job. He built it. He painted it and did the wood grain. He did a good job on this truck.
So what kind of work do you do?
I'm retired 36 years in the oil refinery.
Wow.
Retired.
And after that, now this is your hobby? Or?
This is my hobby, and I walk 3 miles a day, maybe 4 days out of the week. So I keep active.
Wow, that's great. So, man, geez, I wish I could, I remember my own family having a truck like this from such a long time ago, but man, sure we're sorry now that we sold it,
Oh yeah, yes. I had a 50 feet line, and when I bought it, it had coating over the chrome, and I was only 17 when I had it, 16 or 17, and if I had that today, it would be worth about $50,000 easily. It was original seats with seat covers on them. The seats hadn't even been broken in.
So what's the ultimate goal? Do you want to fix this up and eventually sell it? Or?
To me, this is just a material thing. I always tell everyone my father gave it to me, the Lord, above. So this is just a material thing. If I find the car that I want to buy, I would like to buy a 1940 convertible. This car, this truck, I'd sell it in a whim, because it's just a material thing.
So you have a dream car too, though.
Yes, I do. I have a 1938 also, a Master Deluxe. Yeah.
So one of the things you have that's different than most of the other car clubs is that you've got a siren in your car?
Yes. My siren is as loud as a fire truck. That's what Viejitos is known for. It's when we roll up, you hear us. And when we leave, you hear us going. But and throwing up the V for Viejitos Harbor Area.
Well, that's a good way to get everybody out of the way. Turn the siren on, huh?
The fire, when I hit this siren, the fire trucks pull over.
Uh-oh.
I never do it in the public, in the roads, only at a car show.
Now, where do you get a siren?
One of our friends was selling them, so we bought them. The majority of the members have them.
Oh, yeah. Wow, that's awesome. I'm talking to Tony Martinez. He is from the Viejitos Car Club as well. He has got one of those most immaculate cars I've ever seen. This thing is better than brand new. Tony, how long have you been working on this?
About 3 years.
Wow. Where'd you get it?
Up in Hanford, up towards Fresno.
Wow.
Picked it up there. It was probably about 60, 70% done and just finished it up.
Wow. What made you get into fixing up cars?
Just always wanted one, but, couldn't afford one with the kids, and now the kids are gone, so I can get a car.
Get rid of the kids, and now you got a real toy, right?
Yeah.
All right. There you have it, guys. The Viejitos Car Club in a harbor area here.
I speak for the clubs, all the clubs. I speak for our community and for the young kids. Get involved in low riding. It's an experience no one can understand until you do it.
Thank you very much, Howie. The Pharaoh's Car Club is another example of an organization providing positive family activities in the community. They teach youth about vintage cars. They organize annual car shows and outings. They raise funds for several great causes in the community. And they organize an annual holiday toy drive every year. One of my favorite parts of the day is when the event ends. All the cars parade out of the parking lot, making their last little show. The last car is a truck full of toys for the kids. The Women and Teen Center thanks the Pharaohs and other car clubs for their generosity. Hundreds of kids will benefit from your efforts. We're going to leave you with some music and videos of some of the rest of the car show. I'm Mike Herrera. We'll see you next time on Harbor Speaks.